Quisana fades away, a portal to the first challenge of the Shroud appears.
Somebody just opened the portal to the Shroud. You might want to get here quick.
Two more gateways from the battleground open.
Where'd you die at, G? Here comes Rez.
Another Eldritch. This one is distinctly different from the one in Meridian. Gateway to the next of the Giant's challenges appears before you.
I'll be there in a minute. Working on it.
Thank you.
been much better than yesterday.
Somebody want to click the altar?
Wasana's voice echoes through the veil.
The trip to the last moon will be traumatic. Do not abandon your quest yet. Trust in
Hello, everybody. I see chat's not working correctly, so let me see if I can figure out what's wrong with that. Ah, there we go. That's better. So, hello, Commander Eros.
Oh, wonder. Can I have it?
And Ace Evolution. Thanks for watching. And thanks to Skunk, Feeder, QBA, who've been on for a while. Watch me do one, or Rulers of the Realm, and then over here on DDO. Yeah, so I was sleeping on the couch practically next to me, which is why I'm talking quietly. Hey, Cypherwolf, how's it going? I finished my microwave foe. I'm still hungry, so I might have something else here, but now I can at least participate somewhat. I have to type everything. Right now, Guards and Paladins are a safe bet. Parties are always fun. And you have your classics. But right now, with the way the recent updates have been, I would recommend either Bard or Paladin.
Again, fight. Do you know?
Hey, Stack Mechanic, how's it going? Looks like you dropped there for a second. I don't know exactly what's going on. I'm trying to keep on my... Yeah, that happens. I'm trying to get several people to play. They... one or two sessions, they're done for some reason. I've had several people try to get me to play Guild Wars or WoW. Nothing more. I don't have any real interest in those, but this is a lot of fun. I have a lot of fun playing this. The thing about DDO is it's so flexible. The classes and all your enhancements and Epic Destinies and all that make it really flexible. You can do a lot of fun stuff with it. I would say regular completionist is probably not worth it, but epic completionist probably is. In a minute here, I can go over why I think that. Let me just finish this quest and get out of the party so I'm not holding anybody up. Anything? There we go.
Anybody need a shard?
Yeah, if anybody's got any that they don't want, I can use them, that's for sure.
Alright. Let me just get my reward, otherwise I'll forget. Oh, look, a Supreme Shard, darn it. I don't really need that at the moment. I'll take the medium ingredient. Alright, so let me get over here out of the way of everybody. And let me preface this by saying I did not understand Epic Destinies and how they worked until I was actually epic and started messing with them. So let's start with the map view. So there's 12 different epic destinies in 4 different spheres, 3 each. And depending on the your primary class is what you get. So I started in Martial and I started with Legendary Dreadnought. As you gain experience with that epic destiny active, you can level up in it. And when you get 3, you can start in the same sphere in the next ones. So when I got to level 3, I could get over to Grandmaster of Flowers, which is the monk one. I get over to Shadow Dancer, which is the rogue one. When you get 4 and you're in one of these connection ones, then you can get over to a different sphere. And that gives you the chance to get the rest of them, so you can get them all. That's what I'm saying. You can max them all out, which is what I have here on this character. Now, the twists are, if you want an ability from a destiny that's not active, you can twist it in. So even though I'm in Divine Crusader right now, I have this Rejuvenation Cocoon, which is from Primal Avatar. And I have this Unearth Reactions, which is from Magister, I think. And I have Sense Weakness, which is from Primal Avatar, I believe. So you can actually twist in things from a destiny that you're not in, because you only have one destiny active at a time. And the destinies themselves work kind of like enhancement trees. So you have the cores across the bottom as you level up, and then you have points that you can spend to the stuff up above. And some of them have arrows, which are prerequisites, and things like that. So... yeah, basically, it's like an epic version of a class, and there's 12 of them you can choose from. And it's really interesting to mix and match, and when you want to level up, and then you have to be that destiny for that whole, was it like 2 million XP to get it. So it's a lot of grinding in classes that may not be very useful to you, but as you get every, I think, 4th
level in Destiny, you get a fate point, which allows you to unlock the twists and level them up. So, like, you start with 1 point for one twist, and the second twist slot is 2 points. But you can also upgrade the first twist slot to be second level. So, see how they have tiers? You have to upgrade your twist slot to the tier that you have in there. So if I only had one tier one, then I could only grab these abilities on the bottom row. And then 2, 3, and 4. You can never go above 4. So all the 5th and 6th level ones are the stuff that you can't twist in. You have to be in that Destiny to get. And some of them are really powerful. But, yeah, it's a very interesting system. And if you, for example, if I hit show all here, you can see all of the different abilities. There's a lot of them that you can get. And, of course, only a certain subset are active at a time, and then you twist in you select the ones, because you don't have enough points to get everything, right, in any Destiny. So you sort of select the ones you want, build up. They work like enhancements, so there's prerequisites. You have to spend so many points to get the next one and all that, but you get the ones you want in the tree that you want, and then you twist in the others. Now when you get Epic Completionist, you get another twist slot. So you get a four twists instead of just three, which is very powerful as well. So that's nice. Yeah, it's really awesome system. They do to a certain extent in the fact that, like for example, if I'm this character here is a 18 fighter 2 monk, so some of the stuff in Grandmaster of Flowers, which is the monk one, only apply if you're a monk. If you're a bard and you're in Fate Singer, then you have like song bonuses and duration bonuses to your songs and extra effects to your songs and things like that. So to a certain extent, they synergize better with their primary one, but there's also usually one or two other ones that work well, depending on exactly what you're doing and exactly how you have your character set up. So for example, I love running a Primal Avatar, because it's the barbarian tree. And even though I'm a fighter, I'm an axe-wielding dwarf that's a Kensai and a monk, that particular tree has a lot of good stuff for just doing damage as a melee. So that works as well. Works well, too. Divine Crusader, which I'm in now, is really good. Unyielding Sentinel is another good one for melee classes. You don't get all the benefits because you don't have, like, all the spell points, and you don't have all the turn undeads and things like that for the cleric or the favorite soul or the paladin. But you get a lot of stuff that you work off of based on what you have. And it all kind of stacks up, so your enhancements can stack with Epic Destiny stuff. And yeah, it's really deep, fascinating system. That is one of the reasons I really enjoy being at Epic Levels, is playing with all this stuff. Let's see, what else can I show you? And then, of course, by doing Epic Completionist, then you get the Epic Past Life feats. So, for example, I've got double strike here. I get plus 3 double strike, plus 3% double strike per stack, and you can stack 3 times, which I have. I have all 3 times, so it's plus 9% double strike. And then that was for getting 3 melee epic past lives. And then I've got fast healing, which means not only do I have there's a passive bonus for each of these two. And then that's plus 2 AC, plus 1 AC per 10 character levels. But again, that stacks, and these apply even in heroic levels. So really, the best thing to do is get Epic Completionist. And then if you're going to go Heroic Completionist, do that. It seems like it's a lot better because you have all this stuff that makes you a lot more powerful to deal with. So here's Fast Healing. I've got each minute I get 5 HP plus 5 HP for every 5 character levels. That's healing. And of course, that's triple, so it's actually 15. And then the passive is I get plus 3 maximum HP, plus 4 per 10 character levels. And then power of life and death is, this is what I'm working on now, so I've only got one past life on this. And it's plus 10 positive and negative energy spell power per stack. So this one here is one. So every time you epic reincarnate, you go through a thing where you pick a sphere, and then you pick a destiny, basically. And each destiny has a different active past life's epic past life stance. But they all have the same. In each sphere, the passives are the same. So, for example, I don't remember off the top of my head what the other ones are, but say, and I think another one of the martial ones might be fortification. Each time you get that fortification up to 3 times, which means that's 3 past lives, that you pick that sphere and that destiny, then it all stacks. But regardless, you get the passive, even if you went all 3 different ones. But it's better to go 1, 2, 3 in the same one, so you get whatever one you pick, you're doing a lot better. Yeah, Skunk, that's another good point. If you're going to do it, now's probably the time to get it done. I will also say that to epic reincarnate, you need 6 million XP in one sphere. So you can see here I'm building my divine back up. The other ones already have 6 million, but this one needs to be built back up to 6 million so that I can epic reincarnate again from this sphere. So I again get that third stack. And then after that, I have to go arcane, which I'm looking forward to, because as a melee fighter, arcane doesn't have too much for me. It has a couple things that are good, but nothing really groundbreaking. Nothing really important. So yeah, that's a quick overview. Hopefully that helped a little bit. Go on the wiki if you want to know more details of that. But I really, even though I looked at the wiki, I looked at forum post talking about it, I didn't really understand it until I was up here doing it. When you're reincarnate, what do you lose? What you lose, depending on what kind of, there's 4 different kinds of reincarnation, right? There is, actually, you know, the best thing to do, let me go ahead and go to, where is it? And it is reincarnation. There it is. Let me point you to this, because it helps you figure out what's going on. That's the general reincarnation entry, and then specifically this here. Because that goes over a lot of the details on what happens when you reincarnate the different ways. So I've been epic reincarnating, so I really don't lose much. You really only lose your XP from 20 to 28, and then your karma from the sphere you pick. So it's not a big deal. If you iconic or heroic, you lose a lot more. But you get extra build points, so you know, you have that to think about too. Yeah, enchant weapon is what I might go with. I haven't decided yet when I get to arcane. It's just going to... Arcane just doesn't support me as well as the other classes do, since I'm a melee. So when you're in that destiny, you lose a lot of the fun stuff you have from your destinies that synergize better. It doesn't. So once you've unlocked the destinies, you've got them. So the cool thing about epic reincarnation is... You come in, you pick a destiny, and you've got all your stuff back. So at level 20, when you come into Divine Crusader, you have everything back that you had before. So if everything maxed, no matter what I switch to, I have it all maxed already. And you redo your fate points, but basically you have your three twist slots, and you can twist in whatever you want that you've already unlocked. So once you're maxed, it's level 20 isn't nearly as bad. That first time you're level 20 is horrible. because difficulty goes up quite a bit, and but you don't have the destinies. So you don't have your twists, you don't have all your destiny stuff, so you really aren't that powerful. And of course, it's the first time there, and you don't have a lot of gear. It can be tough those first couple levels of Epic. But once you start getting your destinies, then it's a lot nicer. A lot more fun. You get a lot more XP per quest. You don't really, there's not really, I don't think, any other major benefit other than I think it's a lot easier to level from 20 to 28 than I do from 1 to 20. Specifically from like 12, 14 to 20. On a good week, I can hit 20 to 28 in a week. And yeah, a lot of the quests are the same. So if you like quests that are in heroic, there's a chance that they are also epic, and you can run the same quests in epic. They just have different mobs and stuff. In order to the epic completionist, yeah. Yeah, but reincarnate 12 times. Yep, exactly, Skunk. Plus, you've been farming, weapons, the epic weapons and gear and stuff, so. Oh, yeah. And when you first get to epic, you can still do level 18 and 19 quests. That is a good point, Nerdy Dexter. I misunderstood what you said, but yeah, that's also a good point. Looks like a frenzy's going on now, according to that. Let's see, what did I usually use? There we go. Yep, there's a frenzy on Thelanus right now. So if you want to do mimic kind of thingies, now's your time. I have done that too much in the past couple days, so I'm gonna take a break. Not do that. Let's see. My quest and my ransack. Okay, I can join this. It is part of the reincarnation process. After you choose your heart, which heart you're using, and all that. You can have. Oh, the stances themselves are just like feats. Oops, why did I go harbor? I'm trying to go to house K. Not paying attention, hold on. You just drag it to your bar and activate it. You can see I have my bar up here. I don't know if I have links on or off, Dexter. So I'm not sure if it'll kick you or not if you post a link. I really don't know off the top of my head.
Into the vault's central shaft, already secured by the Laughing Knives. The Master Thieves stand ready to offer you their assistance.
Did that work? I'm watching an IRC, so I can't necessarily tell what goes on with Twitch-specific things like that.
Now Vampirus Bale stands here, taut and ready for action. The glyph on the portal reads, "A temple."
Okay, then let me
must seems impossible that only a third of the gate's power is generated here.
So I can see it to copy paste it. Yeah, it's one from each sphere.
Nice. Got the cover.
Yeah. So you can see right now. I've got double strike up here, and fast healing, and power over life and death. Oops. Where am I going? So I have all three going at the moment. And those work in heroics too, can you believe that? It's just, yeah, it's kind of ridiculous how powerful you can get just with the extra past lives.
Gulp everything down you got.
Seriously, just pull that somewhere.
Fortunately, the Rust Emperor was unable to digest the vault's master key.
That's ridiculous. Congratulations on that. Which did it drop in?
Mistress Orkney looks exhausted, but she manages a shy smile of welcome. The glyph on this portal reads Gate of Night. A unique system of.
Do we have enough down there? No, we don't.
Down. That should be four.
Four down?
We're still waiting for the east portal conduit to be lit.
Yep. We got two on the pipe. Ready to go.
Wow, that's awesome.
Go ahead and hit the letters.
Well, don't pull them on your own. Need a countdown.
Do we have four on the levers down low? Oh, he's away.
So congratulations on that. That was pretty cool.
Ladder's down. Good job.
Makes me want to run this quest even more to get the... Got the rest of the Sword of Shadow. I just need that one last piece. If anybody doesn't know that, the Epic Sword of Shadow is still one of the really, really, really rare items in the game. You need four things that are all fairly rare drops to put it together. I guess I have three scrolls and three seals already. I need the shard. So you need the Sword of Shadow, the scroll, the Sword of Shadow, the seal, the Sword of Shadow, and the shard, the scroll, the Sword of Shadow. Then you can make the actual Epic Sword of Shadow. Somebody who just joined to get all the way up here.
Is everybody in yet?
No.
Okay. Do not talk yet.
Okay. Yeah. Okay, I promise I won't talk anymore. Oops, sorry.
Comedian. I was muted. That's why you didn't hear me chuckle. See, I just got 136k XP on that quest. Well, raid. Trying with the comedy and no one's biting on it. Delayed blast fireball. I did not save against it.
Get her stand back and res her at the portal for the dragon.
So evasion was really important, and now you've got the armor pass happened. And
They forgot her stone.
So it's more important to have PR and MMR, which is physical resistance rating, magical resistance rating. Those are much more important now. Thank you for that.
Anybody got the stone yet?
No, that's great.
Yes, thank you. I'm glad somebody actually picked it up. That was nice. Because the reason it's less important is because the evasion, you still have to make the roll. And PRMR happen all the time. Every time, so it's more consistent. That said, at the moment I'm still evasion with my two monk levels because I was getting killed in Travis way too much in heroics, so I figured it would be really bad in epics if I didn't do something about it. And at the time, the armor pass hadn't happened, so evasion was still the thing to get. Hey, Buff Manda, how's it going? Can't see my timer on consecration. There we go. That's a fun ending. I still like the ending where we wiped on Demon Queen, but the Druid pet killed her. So that was fun. I have a video of that somewhere, but I think it's still private. It was a guild thing. Thanks all. There we go. Yeah, it's funny when the raid boss
for the run, guys.
Survives your deaths, but then you actually end up being able to res and loot. No matter the reason, it's fun. So that was an easy 130k XP. I highly recommend running that quest. Sorry, raid every 3 days. It is so worth it. Oh, Titan's doing a Fall of Truth. I don't really care to do Fall of Truth at the moment. Maybe if I was... See, look, there's another one already starting for Vault of Night. let's see, how close am I to level? I've got a bit. Trying to decide what else I want to do here. I don't really want to do the Orchard Slayers. I don't really want to do that. None of that stuff looks fun at the moment. So, let's see. Do I want to do Druids, Chains, or let's do House P? Do some Party Crashers and Snitch. I still need my piece of the Antique Great Axe. It has been so long and I still don't have it. I was even in an EE group the other day and still didn't get it. Full EE group. I've run this quest so many times and I still don't have it. That's so annoying.
The sounds and smells of the busy tavern drift in from the next room. Perhaps Roderick Nettle won't cause a scene if you ask him a few discreet questions in a public place.
Yeah.
stench of smoke wafts down the corridor.
One more level I can put on my orchard gear. That was a nice lag. Put a jump lag there.
If you could lower one of the nearby ladders, you would be able to climb up onto the rooftops. As you turn the valve, you hear a metallic clang in the distance, and angry squeals nearby. As you open the valve, the muffled sound of gears turning can be heard from the water below. Your pursuit has led you out of Tanner's Alley and into a quieter, more... Watchdogs dream peacefully in the sunshine below. If you're careful, you can catch up to Roderick Nettle and still let sleeping dogs lie.
Yeah.
Roderick Nettle's familiar giggle can be heard.
Is there any more questions about the game or anything? Left the channel. Never mind. You'll do no such thing.
Air in the Illusionarium is different than outside, as if you were transported into the deep jungles of Zendrick. As with anything built by House Fiala, it is difficult to tell what is real and what is illusion.
With a mark in there, we go, finally.
The illusions around you dissipate. The way deeper into the Illusionarium is open.
Just forget about stone skin.
The air suddenly shifts from tropical heat to bitter cold. It is as if you were teleported leagues away, rather than just a few feet. These arches have signal crystals attached on top. Are they simply decorative? With House Fiarland, one. Though you can see the rest of Stormreach through the skylights above, the light from outside does not reach this room. The only illumination comes from phosphorescent mushrooms.
Unless I have to.
The Mark of Shadow created copies of itself. They must be illusions. Only destroying the real one will end this death trap. That must have been. The illusionary ones have disappeared, as well as the barrier into the next chamber. Unlike the previous room, this place feels like it's baked in sun. It's surprising that anything could live here. That scorpion completely enveloped the Mark of Shadow. You will need to destroy it in order to get it. The destruction of this make-believe scorpion has also extinguished the Mark of Shadow. The illusionary barrier is gone.
Not much to say here. This is sort of relaxing for me. I do these
days. Particularly on this character. Just trying to get to 27. So that I can get my other gear on. Get 28. Do it all over again. Yay.
The marks of shadow around this chamber are restoring the illusionary giant's health. Through the gauntlet of House Fialin's Illusionarium, but you still need to enter the chapter house and stop the Maleficent Cabal's attack. The Fialin Chapter House must have been closed as a precaution during the Grand Gala. The ballroom is on the far side of the Chapter House, and it seems rather unlikely that next to the security gates, a large dragon mark of shadow is embedded into the wall. If it were to activate, you would not be able to destroy it as you did with the marks in the Illusionarium.
Want to do that?
The Chapter House Theater normally hosts stage plays for Fialin's elite patrons. It looks like it's
he spies on 4 and 3. I should, if it's still open after this, I'm gonna go join that group. I gotta be careful on the EEs since. Still not at the point where that's a cakewalk for me. Yet.
The illusions in this display hall don't appear to be interactive like the ones in the Illusionarium. They probably won't attack.
Hey, NR Towers, how's it going? Welcome.
You finally reached the House Fialin Grand Gala. Now, to find the guest list and add Cyan's name. The party guest here seems like a harmless old elf, but that facade does not fool you. You easily see through to the malicious tiefling underneath.
Farted. Whew, man. He is I gotta pay attention a little bit here. I'm scrolling back in chats to see what if I missed anything. Just a minute. This character. It didn't go well. Hopefully this will go better. Poison on my stomach. On my stomach. There it is. And we are ready to go. Oh good, this is best scenario as he comes out by himself. Oh, of course he dances me. Stuns me. This is why you kill casters first. There we go. I should be okay now. Need a better will save against that stuff. Let's see if I do that. 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 In theory, I should be able to catch up. Off, just not worrying about it.
You hear a woman's voice asking for help up the road.
Late, so mostly just gonna pike this, I think.
Kaylan deftly climbs her way out of the sewer, pausing once to look back and wave her thanks. Fire and brimstone assail your nostrils as elementals appear in the pit. They won't let you pass without a fight.
Just check it. Looks like the stream is going well still. This is one of those times, oh, you know what, that's what I should do, I should bring my rogue out. I'll hit 27 and then bring my rogue out. That sounds like a good idea. I haven't played my rogue in a while.
The last of elementals perishes, and you hear a fresh gust of air escaping the pipes near the ceiling hatch.
of the tunnel shows you have reached the end of your journey. You have found the far end of the Blood Road.
Sweltering heat in these tunnels is almost unbearable. Who would want to live in such a place? An earth elemental rises from the ground, blocking the only safe path. A warforged worker beckons to you from inside the foundry. RC2 stops abruptly and rocks back and forth in a daze. Quite obviously, something is wrong. Even through your clothing and armor, you can feel the floor grow warmer.